Hello guys, and welcome to Python Programming Tutorials by Amul's Academy. In the previous tutorial, we discussed about the different ways to create dictionaries in Python. Today, we'll see how to access the elements from the dictionary as well as how to insert new element to the dictionaries. Okay, so here we can see we created a dictionary called MyDict. Okay, so these are the elements. Here 1, 2, 3 are keys and apple, ball and cat are the values. So now if you want to access all the keys from this dictionary, then we can use keys function for that. So here you need to mention the dictionary name dot keys, and in Python 3 it will return a dictionary object, and here we can see the keys. And if you want to access values in the dictionary, then here you can use values function, so dot values, and here we can see the values. And here in Python 3, even this function also returns a dictionary object. Okay, here we can see. But if you use these functions in Python 2, then it will return list. Okay, so here we can see, here I'm using Python 2, and here we use the same function that is dictionary.keys and dictionary.values, and it will give the output in the list form. Okay, so this is the difference in Python 2 and Python 3. So in Python 3, this function will return a dictionary object. Okay, so next, if you want to access the single element, then you can use keys and you can access the values. For that, MyDict, here I'll mention the key as 3. So I want that value for which key is 3. Okay, and enter, and here we can see cat, and here we can see at key 3 value is cat, right? So we got that. So using keys we can access the values from the dictionary, but using values you can't access the keys. For example, if I write, here I'll write apple, okay, this is the value, and enter, and here we can see the error. And to access the values, there is another method, that is using get. So dot get, and here you need to mention the key. If I mention 1, I'll get apple. Okay, in this method, if you didn't get the key, it will show the error. Here we can see, right? But in the get method, if that key is not present, then it will return none. Okay, so that is nothing but if I try, so I'll write my key as 5, okay, and I'll enter, and here we can see it will return nothing, none. Okay, so but in this method, if I mention 5, it will show the error. So we can access the elements of dictionary using keys. There are two methods, that is by mentioning the dictionary name and keys we can get the value, and the second way is by using get method. So this is about the accessing the elements in the dictionary. Next, we will see how to insert any element to the dictionary. Okay, so next, if you want to insert any new element to this dictionary, then we can do that by, this is the dictionary name, and next here I need to mention the key of that new element. If the key is 4, then here I need to mention the value. And now if I check that, here we can see a new value is added to the dictionary. Right. Next, if you want to update already existing value, okay, so then we can do that. For example, here we can see in this dictionary, second element is this, 2 is the key, ball is the value. So now I want to change this value, then I can do this by using, and here I'll mention new value, that is bat. Okay, so this is the dictionary name and this is the key where I want to update my value. Here this is the new value. And here we can see new value. Okay, so this is about how we can insert new value to the dictionary as well as how we can update values in the dictionary. Next, if you want to find out the length of the dictionary, then you can use length function. So here length of, here you need to mention the dictionary name. And here we can see 4. So it contains 4 elements. So the length of dictionary is 4. So this is about the basic operations of dictionary. Here we learn about how we can access the elements in the dictionary as well as how to insert any element to the dictionary. So that's it for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'll meet you next class. Till then, take care.